Julia Audi. Now it's gone to ground over and it squirts out on the Exeter Chiefs side. It's seen brilliantly by McGuigan. Byron McGuigan. Oh, he's just caught. Tom James, Mitch Lees. Oh, it's brilliant. What a score from the Chiefs. When you are hot, you are very, very hot. What a score. The Exeter Chiefs for years have been all about the teamwork. No superstars and a try that typifies that. But it all started with a turnover. Steenson with the tackle, wasn't it?
Brilliant. You can see James outside there. He's looking for McGuigan. Should it go left? He doesn't matter, but he prefers to step off his left. Gets tagged, then the pull. Jesse's in, 1-2. Receiving the ball back from Lee. That's superb. Brilliant, brilliant skill. Heads up rugby, scanning the situation.
Cordwell, now Witten. Knew he was going to need support, looked around. Hayden Thomas and these forwards are just pouring onto the ball. And it's Brett Sturgis. It's another fabulous offload. And the Chiefs now.
Take off, please.
Virtually scoring at will.
The what, sorry?
But the referee says time off.
I am, but I'm also going to check the forward pass as well.
Well, he believes the forward pass may be put. I personally didn't see it
like this. They won't be a very strong La Rochelle side going down to Sandy Park.
Oh, it's flown out wide, and there it is. There is try number three. McGuigan. Byron McGuigan.
Let's go!
And it was on the cart, wasn't it, against 14. The line-out worked well, and then it was a simple matter of hands.
Hit up, hit up, hit up. And that's when a big loopy pass does work, if it's the last man to go with about 3 yards to go, and he's got 3 yards in from the touchline. He can get on his belly, aquaplane it in. That's a lovely score from McGuigan. And again, is it possible? Steenson, correct decision. This will be favouring his right foot, because he does like slightly to bring it in from right to left. 18, get in there, get in! Oh, get him off.
He is human. After all.
And Kerry Sweeney's just coming on, who could have taken the kick. That's tremendous, Gareth Steenson.
Was Super Steenson. His night is done.
He's done more than he should, really. He's been charging around.
Tom James, oh, it's opened up for him. Now needs support, it's Vinicolo. Oh, it's going to be a dream trip to France for Exeter Chiefs. Gareth Steenson realises it. And this Exeter machine just keeps rolling on.
Well, Rob Baxter, you have had your dream come true. The crowd is definitely silent. It has been going silent since the first try, and it's gone pretty quiet, and people are leaving now with a couple of minutes to go. Bonus point. Gareth Steenson knows it. He celebrates. He's been the architect for most of the game, 70 minutes. Dean Munn's on the bike behind. You won't be needing you, mate. Hayden Thomas is a smile on the bike. And that's just a good all-round performance.
All right, we've got the chance to talk now and go live over to France. We're captain and Homme Du Match, man of the match this evening. Gareth Steenson is with us. Many congratulations on your own personal performance, Gareth, and also on the team's performance. That style of game caught us out a little bit in the first half in particular. Was it what you planned on doing?
Yeah, we planned on coming over and putting, you know, a lot of tempo in the game. It was definitely a very physical game. We felt we were fitter, and if we put our game on them and played with a lot of tempo, you know, we'd tire their big boys out.
Hi, Gareth. It's TJ here. Well done, mate. Congratulations on your new three-year contract. Well deserved. I just wanted to know, defensively, it looked a lot tighter in the second half. I just wondered if anything was said at half-time by the coaches or by you guys to tighten it up.
Yeah, I think just in the first half we didn't make our completions, we didn't complete a lot of tackles. You know, we were putting hits in, but they were sort of riding us a wee bit, and it was just a real focus on trying to, you know, get some tackles in there and complete the tackle sets at the end, and we're very pleased.
Looks
looks like you're enjoying yourselves down there. Well done. Well, you might as well. A quick question, although it's, I know, just moments after full-time whistle, your ambitions within this competition, because in a, what is a very tight pool, you've now got a pretty healthy lead and must be considering your future within it beyond Christmas and onwards to the knockouts.
You know, we're doing quite well on all fronts, and absolutely, you know, like, we've had a good block in the Premiership to come away and with the last block and get three good wins. And it was nice to come into a different competition, and it's definitely put us in good stead now going into next week as well. So hopefully we can come away with a result there. You know, will set us up really good, and also will lead us nicely back into the Premiership.
Gareth, Stuart Barnes here, well played. Good win collectively for the team, but psychologically, what sort of shape are you in having missed a kick at goal? I mean, you're going to have to work very hard on your practicing now, my friends.
Yeah, I'll be back out next week. We've got the weekend off now, so we'll get back to it on Monday. But, you know, it was just a matter of hopefully getting the opportunity to get the bonus point at the end. It was debate whether to go for a drop goal or not there, just to get the game speeded up. But, yeah, absolutely delighted to come away and get 5 points in France. So it's very tough for any team, and we're delighted with it.
And well, you might be. Don't listen to Barnsley. We don't. 18 from his last 19. So there's nothing wrong with that, Gareth. Well done, mate.